This is the Friday Night 360 AZ Preview Show. Haley Stasiak and Jordan Hamm here. It is the final week of the regular season. The playoffs are coming for us. A lot is going on around high school football. I think both of us are kind of our heads. Jordan's got a computer issue that he's been dealing with, so he's got old school paper notes.
It's a really nice, it's a very expensive paper holder right now, so that's cool.
He's going to work on getting that fixed, but we've got a really great show for you today. We're going to have Will Babb, Peoria head coach, call in with us, Jacob Conover, Chandler senior quarterback, and Cam Cox from 12 News Sports is going to call in and talk broad stuff with high school football. But first, let's get to the big story surrounding the high school football scene, and that's Spencer Rattler and his season being done. A lot of opinions out about this, a lot of speculation out about this. Right now, it's all just rumors and speculation.
And let's start with the report. And it was originally reported by AZ Central by Richard Obert. Spencer Rattler's father came to him and let him know that his season was over, and it was because of a code of conduct violation. That can mean a lot of different things. So I wanted to get that out there.
Yeah.
First, we're not going to talk about what it potentially could be. You know, this isn't the rumor mill. We're not going to take the show this way. But I wanted to get that note out there before we went ahead and discussed
definitely.
Any of it. So
agreed. I mean, just looking at this, first of all, one of the big things that I've seen is why they discipline him now? Why not wait until after the playoffs? Pinnacle's not going to get to that state title that they were hoping to this year. Either way, if they had waited to do this after the playoffs, people would be upset that they waited and didn't discipline him when it happened. So there's no winning there. Second of all, if you've seen this Pinnacle team, you know that they are not out of this fight.
Right.
And I did see that firsthand I think it was the second week of the season against Mountain Point when J.D. Johnson did have to come in and step up for Rattler after he went down with an ankle injury. I don't think there's reason to be worried necessarily. Like, this Pinnacle team is still good, and J.D. Johnson is a good quarterback. In the terms of football stuff, this is a blip in the radar for this Pinnacle team.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think Spencer Rattler would be the first one to say that Spencer Rattler let down Pinnacle.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's been the guy for 4 years, and from everything that I've heard about him over the past 4 years and covering him and getting to know him, he handled his business each and every day since he was a freshman and started from his first game. And that includes athletics, that includes academics. He'd go on the national stage with the Elite 11, and he won the MVP. He's had a documentary series following him around, and it seems like he was handling his business. And the first time I've heard of anything is a couple days ago. Mm-hmm. So yes, he did let his team down. And I think that, again, he would be the first one to go ahead and admit that. But like you said, this is now, it's unfortunate that this is how his career ends. It's unfortunate for the seniors that don't get to run out with their quarterback, you know, that has been their guy for the past 4 years. But you have a guy in J.D. Johnson that they can still go make something of this season and, you know, go make that title run and try to, you know, it's Chandler's been the standard at 6A. They want to go take a shot at Chandler. I think J.D. Johnson is equipped to go ahead and do that. And now it's just a matter of they know who their quarterback is, because when it was, you know, rumors that it was an injury and things like that, there was a lot of haziness, even within the program of, okay, well, is it going to be J.D.? Is it going to be Spencer? Now it's J.D. They can go ahead and move on, and Spencer can hopefully learn from this and, you know, take those life lessons and move on to, you know, the next phase of his life.
My big thing with this, and the first thought I had was, you know what, you do live and you learn. That's something that is one of my kind of life mottos. I'm going to be putting a blog post up after the show, little notebook, kind of on my thoughts about the situation and just life and making mistakes. So keep an eye out for that up on the website. Don't want to dwell on this too much because it is the last week of the regular season and there are a lot of great football games being played. So let's go ahead and switch gears into that. First game up on the list is Campo Verde at Castile. Jordan, I know you've seen Campo Verde, really solid team there. Castile has come a long ways from the beginning of the season when they had some early season struggles. Obviously, that first season or that first game loss against Liberty. What are you seeing here with this one?
I feel like with this game, I've seen both of these teams at their absolute best. Campo Verde had a comeback win against Ironwood Ridge earlier this year to go 5-0. And then I saw Castile really take it to a really good Higley team. And that was kind of their first statement win of 5A. So I'm expecting this to be a really good game. Matt Leisure is the guy for Campo Verde. I liken him to the Toby Gerhart of the Coyotes. And then Castile, they're just rock solid. And really, I feel like starting to hit their stride. Right now, I believe they're a 4 seed. in this really tough 5A, but Campo's just been going through the ringer schedule-wise. It's a really tough 5A Santan region, as we talk about almost each and every week, but they're kind of hitting the bulk of that schedule right now.
In terms of Liberty at Chaparral, now Chaparral is without their quarterback in Jack Miller. Mm-hmm. They're going to backup quarterback. This is kind of a conversation we're having right now with these really star quarterbacks that are out, mm-hmm. whatever the reason. With Chaparral down a quarterback, I mean, there's still quite a few playmakers on this Chaparral team. This Liberty team is pretty solid. You've seen both of these teams this season, right, as well. What are you seeing with this specific matchup?
And this is kind of a sneaky rivalry game. Mm-hmm. These teams, it's always a really tough game when they play each other. And it's been a bit since they played, I believe. But Liberty, that defense is so good, and it's gonna be not as much of a strength for strength because Jack Miller is out, but like you said, you still have a ton of playmakers across the way for Chaparral. Chaparral right now a 13 seed, and Liberty is the 3 seed. Mm-hmm. So Chaparral definitely could make some leaps up there. I think they're safe for a playoff spot. Mm-hmm. But again, they wrapped up the year with another really tough schedule at the end of the year. Last week playing Pinnacle, I know it wasn't the game that we all thought it would be at the beginning of the year. Rattler against Miller, neither one of them were able to play. But they lost that game 23-7 last week.
Queen Creek at Desert Vista, this is another one where the starting quarterback is out. We wish Devin Larson all the best in his recovery from shoulder surgery, which he had earlier this week. But I don't think that we count Queen Creek out here yet, because Devin Larson has a lot of playmakers around him that can get the job done. I think sometimes we look at these starting quarterbacks and all these quarterbacks in Arizona, and we think this is the leader of this team, this is why this team is winning. I do not think that is the case with Queen Creek at all. I saw Desert Vista against Boulder Creek. I was out at that game. We've talked about that quite a bit, where freshman Devin Grubbs had 5 rushing touchdowns. Desert Vista, you know, there's a lot of guys there that can get it done too. I think they're kind of an underrated team this year.
Yeah, and I think they had they were out of state for 2 of their games to start the year. And once they hit their region play, that's when they started playing some really good teams. So it's kind of like, the competition we were unfamiliar with to start the year with Desert Vista. But I completely agree with what you said about Queen Creek. Ryan Dobbs was also out. Their number one wide receiver in the game last week against Highland. I'm hearing that he should be ready to go for the playoffs, maybe the second round of the playoffs. It's still kind of up in the air, but he's definitely a game changer for them. And my guess right now is it's Trey Reynolds who's going to be the backup quarterback for Devin Larson. I watched him play running back, play linebacker. He's a much different quarterback than Devin Larson, because it's kind of like, if you know Oklahoma football from a few years ago, Blake Bell, where it's just like, this guy's really like a fullback, but he
can do everything.
He's playing quarterback. Mm-hmm. So I anticipate them to really rely on the run. You have Dylan Borja, who's a really good running back, but Trey Reynolds certainly can get out in the open, and he's not going to shy away from hits either. So it's obviously, it's a huge loss when you have a senior leader like Devin Larson that goes down, but I think that they also have a defense that could set themselves up to still make some noise in the postseason.
Higley at Williamsfield now. I saw Higley against Gilbert last week. Pretty impressed there. Obviously, Spencer Brash at quarterback for them. We talk about playmakers around these quarterbacks, and Higley's definitely one of those teams that has those guys too. Williamsfield, always a good team to watch too.
Yeah, absolutely. These are 2 of the more consistent programs in the entire state. I think that Williamsfield is one of the best offensive lines in this state, and Higley, talent-wise, is the best defensive line. So that's going to be fun to watch, strength versus strength in that one. Williamsfield also has an incredible secondary, so you know that Spencer Brash loves to get the ball out to his playmakers. Coleman Owen, if you throw the ball in the same zip code, he's going to come down with it.
Saw that last Friday against Gilbert.
Yeah, and I saw it against Castile, too, where him and Zach Nelson, it was just like, if you just put it on one side
of
the field and they'll go,
they'll go
track it down. So the secondary against this Higley pass game, I think, is also going to be really fun.
We're not going to break these games down too much. Let's take a look at these real quick, though. Perry at Basha, Chandler at Hamilton, and another one we want to mention is Cactus at Peoria. check out our wonderful tech producer, Devin Larson's special on that.
The MVP of the preview show.
Yes, he did a really good piece on that meeting, 33rd meeting between Cactus and Peoria. We'll go over Chandler and Hamilton a little bit with Jacob Conover as well, but let's just touch real quick on this Perry at Basha. Basha's coming off a loss to Brophy. Mm-hmm. Perry, obviously, I think we haven't really talked a lot about Perry, but there's a lot there for Perry. Joe Purdy stepped up. A lot of guys around them, after losing a couple guys to injury earlier in the season, have really stepped up as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And Preston Jones has said that the difference in this team is the running backs that they have. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit different of an offense, but still very high-powered. And they have kind of been cruising lately. They got beat by Pinnacle early in the year. I feel like some of them kind of wrote them off, and they're like, well, this isn't Brock Purdy's team anymore, so
yeah,
whatever. But they are still super talented. I think they're a team that could make some noise in the postseason. We heard Mark McClune last week say Chuba Purdy and Perry's going to upset someone. He doesn't know who. He doesn't know at what point. Right now they're sitting at the 5 seed. They're going to upset somebody. So that's going to be something to look out for. Bash has been rock solid as well. Huge leaps and bounds from last year where it was a tough year. They've got a lot of size along the offensive line, and that's been a strength for them. But Coach McDonald's done a great job, kind of turning that program around. And then you have a big rivalry game in Chandler Hamilton. Hamilton has struggled. Chandler seems pretty bulletproof right now, but it's still a rivalry game, and weird stuff happens in rivalry games.
Know.
So I'm looking forward to that. I'm actually going to be doing play-by-play for that one on Sports 360 AZ. So looking forward to checking that game out.
Coming up next on the Friday Night 360 AZ preview show, we're taking a look at this rivalry game between Peoria and Cactus with Peoria head coach Will Babb. Keep it right here.